Hey guys, I want to do a quick video on Psalm 119. And Psalm 119 is the longest chapter in the Bible. And it has some unique qualities. It's divided into 22 sections. And each section represents a letter of the Hebrew alphabet. And each division has 8 verses within it. So for instance, the first 8 verses are under the Hebrew letter A or Aleph, verses 9 through 16, or for the letter Beth, and so on and so forth. And all of these verses discuss the Word of God and uses synonyms for the Word of God within just about every verse to describe the attributes of the Word of God. And the synonyms include precepts and testimonies and law and commandments, statutes, ways, and obviously the Word. And so when reading Psalm 119, this is a great way to really meditate on the purity of God's Word, the Bible, the King James Bible, that we can trust it, that it's without error, the power of it. But we can also see the Word of God within Psalm 119 with a capital W, which is Jesus Christ, obviously. It says in John 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in 1 John 5:7, for there are 3 that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these 3 are one, which is a great verse about the triune Godhead or Trinity. So, you know, what I want to show today is I want to just read 4 or 5 verses and look at them in a couple of different ways. And I think this may help somebody that gets caught up on, you know, following the commandments, for instance, and you know, do we have to follow the commandments to go to heaven? And what are all these verses that seem to be very legalistic? Does that have to do with my salvation? Once again, you know, as I stated in just about every video, it's not what we do, it's what Jesus Christ did for our salvation. And we can't do anything from our righteousness and our works, our good deeds, to merit eternal life. It's a free gift that is received by faith in Jesus Christ. You know, the gospel is 1 Corinthians 15, that Jesus Christ died for our sins according to Scripture, was buried, and rose again the 3rd day according to Scripture. He paid the sin penalty that we ourselves could never pay. And by acknowledging that we're a sinner and need a Savior, having that repentant heart, as I talked about in the last video, and turning from unbelief, our false beliefs, our dead works, unto the one true God for eternal life through Jesus Christ, that is how to receive eternal life. But getting back to Psalm 119, let's read a few of these verses. And let's start with verse 9. It says, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto according to thy word. So you see the word right here. And, you know, we can read these verses and also be thinking in the back of our minds about the person of Jesus Christ and the deity of Jesus Christ, the everlasting nature, the perfect holiness and righteousness of God in Jesus Christ. So we could look at it as, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed according to Jesus. You know, and this is by no means meant to say we should substitute or change words of the Bible. We know the consequences of that. But this is simply to better appreciate Psalm 119 and better appreciate the Word of God and, you know, in its Holy Scripture, as well as the Word of God in Jesus. we can go to verse 42. So shall I have wherewith to answer him that reproacheth me, for I trust in thy word. And you could say or think about this from, the word again with a capital W, for I trust in Jesus. In Psalm 81, it says, my soul fainteth for thy salvation, but I hope in thy word. And so obviously we receive salvation through Jesus Christ, and we can be thinking also about Jesus when we're reading this verse and say, my soul fainteth for thy salvation, but I hope in Jesus. One of the famous verses that my kids know and I say all the time, 119:105, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. But we also know that Jesus is a lamp unto my feet, our feet, and a light of our path. He is light. He came into the world and lighteth up every man that cometh into the world. And we can certainly, again, be thinking about Jesus Christ when reading this verse. And in verse 160, it says, again, another famous verse, thy word is true from the beginning, and every one of thy righteous judgments endureth forever. We know that Jesus Christ is true from the beginning, and his righteous judgments endureth forever. He is from everlasting. And we don't have to just use examples with a word in it. We could look at the other synonyms for the word of God within this chapter, such as statutes and judgments and commandments and laws. For instance, in verse 142, thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth. We certainly know that the law, the word of God, is truth. But we also know that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. So we could look at this as thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and Jesus is the truth. Just going a couple of verses down to verse 144. The righteousness of thy testimonies is everlasting. Give me understanding, and I shall live. And once again, the righteousness of Jesus is everlasting. He fulfilled the law and the Old Testament, and he is from everlasting. He's God in the flesh, and he gives understanding. And we put our trust in him, we shall live. So this is a great way to look at this verse. Just a few examples to maybe get a better appreciation of Psalm 119. And, and look at it from a couple of different angles. I think that this can really help us look forward, and live in the Spirit and not look backward and look at the legalistic aspects of the law, which certainly are perfect and righteous, and we should live according to these commandments. But we know that no one is perfect, and we're all sinners and need a Savior, and that's what the law was meant to be, a schoolmaster, to help us realize that God is perfect, that his commandments, his laws, spiritual laws, are perfect, and that we can never hold them as sinful flesh, and that we need him in order to receive eternal life. But then once we receive eternal life through faith in Jesus Christ, we should continue in the Word of God. Read Psalm 119 and every other chapter in the Bible, and read it multiple times to grow spiritually and to better be able to live in the Spirit. I think a lot of times that, we tend to look at a lot of the laws and commandments and want to get ourselves and others back under bondage instead of the freedom and liberty of Christ. And I'm just here to say that it's a lot easier to live a righteous life by living in the Spirit and looking forward, and using the Holy Spirit that indwells believers, and looking at Jesus' perfect attributes and using the love that he gives, believers in him to show his holiness through our words, deeds, actions. If we try to use our will and get back under bondage and look at these commandments and try to uphold these commandments with our imperfect righteousness and our will, it's going to be hard. It's going to be difficult. It leads to, I think, somebody that can be judgmental and, they're looking at other people's faults and don't see their faults at all. And it could puff people up and lead to self-righteousness. And, you start spewing that out to others and nobody's going to receive the gospel of Jesus Christ that way. So look forward at the cross. Look forward and live in the Spirit and use Psalm 119 and other chapters like that that discuss the Word of God as a tool to really mature our spirit. And so that'll be it, and we'll talk again soon. God bless.